I think that there were two technologies that transformed television. The first one took place, you know, generations ago, and that was the introduction of a remote control in every box, because all of a sudden people had to get off their butt and, you know, and change a channel, and now they didn't have to, and that totally changed how people view TV. The second was not color TV or high definition or anything, it was the DVR. Because what it enabled people to do very, very quickly and very simply was to essentially time shift programs. And so it has had an enormous impact. And the thing that's so interesting about the DVR is that when we look at technology, we view 40% penetration in the population as becoming mainstream. Well, this year is the year that the DVR will reach that 40%. So for all the years we've been talking about DVRs, and it's been, you know, 5, 6, 7 years, and for all the changes that it's made in terms of how we program, how we sell, even the metric that we use, it was really what you might consider to be an emerging technology. So that just gives you some sense of how profound an impact the DVR is. Now, how do I think about a DVR? I kind of think about it as a frenemy, all right? It's a friend and it's an enemy. So how is it a friend? Well, without any question, DVRs extend reach. Okay, we have many, many shows, The Office is a good example, where over 40% of the rating of that program over the 7 days that Nielsen measures it, you know, is done on a time-shifted basis. And so, you know, that's a very, very significant difference. And that's why when we look at numbers every day, and we're looking at essentially the number of people who watched it live or DVR'd on the same day, we're looking really at about, you know, only half of really the amount of viewing that will take place on any particular program. And so a show like The Office, and there are many others, you know, benefits from the fact that its reach, the number of people who watch it, is actually extended by the DVR. The second reason it's helpful is that The Office is an interesting program. It's a great show and has a great fan base, but it's also in a very, very competitive time period. If we were in an environment without a DVR, we would be in a situation where people would have to make a choice between, you know, Grey's Anatomy or The Office. Now they don't have to make that choice. And so the fact of the matter is, it's sort of like everybody wins, because people watch one of those shows first, and then they watch the other one at some other time, whereas they don't have to make that kind of, you know, choice of one, and they never get to see the other. The other thing is very interesting from a business standpoint, is that contrary to popular belief, people actually do watch commercials on DVRs, and when there's a show that's highly time-shifted, like an Office, the number of people, the commercial rating, the rating that we monetize with our advertising clients, which is the rating of people who watched it, the commercials from the first, second, and third day, is actually higher than the original live commercial rating. And the reason is that even though, yes, there are some people who skip commercials, I know that that's hard to believe. We should make it a felony, but it's not. The fact of the matter is that it's one of those things where a rising tide lifts all boats. So there's so much more viewing that even though there can be some breakage, at the end of the day, we're actually delivering more people to the advertiser than we would have if the DVR didn't exist. So that's where it's a friend. You know, a few years ago, advertisers felt that there was absolutely no value to anything that was seen on a disc, because their assumption was that nobody watched these commercials. Well, you know, that's one of the biggest urban myths going around. And that takes me to the second issue about, you know, is it an enemy? Clearly it has an impact on commercials. And there's no question that people, you know, skip commercials sometimes. The fact of the matter is that in spite of what people say about, I've never seen a commercial in their entire life, I mean, we often go and talk to people about how they use TV and stuff, and we'll say this, and some people will say, I just never see a commercial anymore. And then, you know, 15 minutes later, we'll say, okay, let's just talk about a couple of commercials. And they'll say, oh, I love that commercial with the gecko. I mean, for, you know, so people, of course, do see commercials. What we know from Nielsen is that about 45% of the commercials are on a DVR, when people are watching on DVR, are screened, okay? And so, you know, is it 100%? No, it never was, by the way. People always, you know, surfed and got an apple or went to the bathroom or did any of those kinds of things, but people do see the commercials. The second thing is that not everybody is watching on DVR. I mean, even right now, with 40% penetration, 60% of TV homes don't even have a DVR. So the fact that commercials are still a very valuable you know, way to market it, I mean, I don't think can be debated. What happened was that agencies took a long time to understand that there was value when something was on a video disc, and that was something that took a little bit of a little bit of experience. We needed some data, which we ultimately got from Nielsen, and I think that they've come around to understand that, you know, it's not what it might have used to be, but there are very few things in this world that really are. I mean, we're living in a very different kind of technology world.